UN High Commissioner for Refugees Filippo Grandi is tasting the fruits of an extraordinary experiment. The produce comes from farms tilled by refugees and the host community in Melkadida, Ethiopia, a region that hosts over 200,000 refugees along the border with Somalia. Investment from the IKEA Foundation has gone from beyond life-saving support to help transform this dry and once barren land into a prosperous community. Irrigation schemes help refugees and their hosts harvest crops like watermelon and corn three times a year. They also trade in livestock.
What has developed here is a unique approach to self-reliance of refugees, where the government of Ethiopia has been extremely open to innovative approaches as well. The two communities, the host community, the Ethiopian host community, and the Somali refugees, have been able to work together in harmony.
In 7 years, focus on economic activity has given way to development and opportunity for everyone. IKEA Foundation's $100 million investment has also helped build primary and secondary schools, as well as a training center for teachers. 19-year-old Fartoon is in her final year of high school here in Melkadida and is looking forward to going to university.
If I learn something, education for life, it will set go. So, and education is very important. Education is a light. Education is the way to can who in you. Whom you can satisfy on yourself or your family, or you, it is a progress.
In meetings with community leaders and refugees, the High Commissioner and CEO of IKEA Foundation, Per Higgins, heard how better economic opportunities have helped promote peace.
Well, the local economy is booming not only because of the land that we have irrigated and therefore made possible to grow and farm and make three crops a year, but it's also part of the rise of the community, the livelihood developments, the community developing itself, finding opportunities to live as a normal community, and in this case, refugees and host community together, seeing the opportunities instead of seeing the threats and fighting each other, and of course in the end that also leads to stability.
To build on this success, IKEA Foundation and UNHCR signed a deal to extend their partnership for three more years. It is a sign that inclusion and cooperation between governments, the private sector, and UNHCR can benefit countries hosting refugees and the refugees themselves. The High Commissioner also praised Ethiopia's leadership for the promotion of inclusive policies that make projects like Melkadida possible.
You finish this. Very good. Good luck.
Speaking at the 32nd African Union Summit in Addis Ababa, which this year focused on finding lasting solutions to displacement, the refugee chief called for increased support for countries that keep their doors open. He highlighted the need for a new approach within the Global Compact for Refugees, which promotes investment in infrastructures and economies in areas hosting refugees for the benefit of all.
For the first time, we're implementing the Global Compact on Refugees. People always tell me, when are you going to implement it? We're already implementing it here with the multiple partners cooperating towards development projects, irrigation, education, vocational training.
Projects like this one in Melkadida are an example of how creating opportunities for refugees and their hosts can transform the economy of a region and even promote peaceful coexistence.